This is EIA's new U.S. Electric System Operating Data Tool. And it shows you, in near real time, what's happening on the U.S. grid. Let's cover the basics and how this tool can help you. A big challenge for the U.S. electric system is to create exactly the right amount of electricity for exactly when it's needed. Electricity storage, like batteries, have traditionally been expensive and difficult to build at scale. Managing thousands of power plants so that their generation matches demand can be tricky. Some power plants can spin up quickly to generate power to meet a sudden demand, but may be limited by how much fuel they have available. Others take hours or even days from when they start up until they're providing power to the grid. But once they're up, they have weeks or months of fuel. And others can only generate power in certain conditions. This is where our tool comes in. To help manage this careful balancing act, the thousands of power plants in the U.S. are divided into balancing authorities. You can see these as circles on the map. A balancing authority contains thousands of consumers, people who need or demand power, and dozens of power plants, called generators. These balancing authorities, or BAs, are neighbored by and connected to other balancing authorities. We call these interconnections, and through them, a balancing authority can trade electricity to meet each other's demands. At any given moment, one balancing authority may not have enough electricity to meet its own demand, so it receives surplus electricity from one of its neighbors. Let's take a look at our map. BAs in blue are reporting that their current demand is under their earlier expectations. This could mean that they have excess electricity available for export. BAs in orange are experiencing more demand than they anticipated, so they could be looking to import power. That's a high-level view of how the U.S. electric system works. To dive into the detail of our monitoring tools, check out our other videos.